God wants us to bless us in every way. That's why in Exodus 15:26 he said, I am the Lord who heals you. In Psalm 103 he said, if we read from verse 2 onwards, the Lord does these things. Number one, he pardons all our iniquities. Secondly, he heals us from all our diseases. Third, he redeems us from the pit. Fourth, he crowns us with loving kindness and compassion, that our youth may be renewed. Jesus took our burden, our sickness. This is the truth which we read in the book of Isaiah 53 verse 5. He took away our infirmities. My dear friends, the Lord God has accomplished everything on the cross. He is our healer. He is with us. And as Psalm 34 verse 5 says, look unto him and you will be healed. Look unto the Lord and we will be healed. Today's gospel we heard. He saw the people who are helpless. He saw the people who are scattered. He saw the people who are like sheep without the shepherd. And his heart was broken. Today, are you helpless? Are you crying in your situation? Maybe in your sickness. Maybe in your helplessness. Maybe in your brokenness. Maybe your family is broken. Maybe your finance is broken. Maybe your health is broken. Jesus saw the broken-hearted people. Jesus saw the scattered people. People who are scattered. They were not able to understand each other. They were not able to cope up with each other. They are not able to agree with each other. They were fighting with each other. Man, woman separated. Parents, children are separated. The masters not understanding the employee. Understanding the employers. All kinds of scattered people in the world. And still Jesus says, there were other group of people who are like sheep without the shepherd. If there is no shepherd for the sheep will not know where the danger is lying. What kind of lion is coming behind it? Where to go first of all to eat? Yes, there are people who are helpless in the world. They are like sheep without the shepherd. And the Lord Jesus' heart was broken. And he's healed all of them. That's what the word of God says. Today, the divine mercy means what? Divine mercy means the mercy of God comes from God to the humanity for many things. And one of the things today we reflect is to heal all our brokenness. Brokenness of our body, our mind, and our spirit. The problem with us is, why are we not able to heal? We pray many times. We cry to him. But still, if we are not being healed, maybe the divine mercy is talking to us. Number one, the problem many people face is, many expect a man of God to bring them healing. Is it wrong to ask the servant of God to heal us? Not at all. We have prayed for so many people and God's mercy comes to us. But we should never forget, it is not the human beings who heal us. I have seen so many type of miracles and wonders. A lady who was suffering with 12 years of fits. As we were crying to Jesus, her mercy on her, instantly she was healed. And her husband was saying, 12 years she was having fits. and that fits never came. An evil spirit was living in the form of fits. But when the mercy of the Lord we pleaded, yes, God's mercy came upon her and healed her. But we need to understand, the servants of God can pray to God, but the healing comes from God. Suppose if the servant of God prays and nothing happens to you, or he gives some other results, don't lose courage. The healer is the Lord. Look unto him. Don't lose your courage. We read in the book of 2 Kings chapter 20, that is today's first reading. The king called Hezekiah, he became very sick. He was affected with a sickness called cancer. And he is almost dying. And the word of God came to him through the prophet called Isaiah. And Isaiah said, King Hezekiah, the Lord is telling me to tell you that you get ready, set right your home. You are going to die in your sickness. The prophet, the servant of God, said and went away and going away to his home. But Hezekiah is not prepared. He turned towards Jerusalem, the holy temple, and he began to cry to God, Lord, I am your servant. I have lived a life of faithfulness. And your child cannot die when you are the healing. When you are having healing, how can your child die of sickness? No! You have to do something for me. God likes this kind of prayer. That you claim that your God has the healing. You claim there is nothing impossible for your God. And you will not die even if the servant of God has said. Because my God, if he thinks I can be healed. If this kind of prayer life you have, God will honor you. So, as Isaiah said, the servant of God said to the king that you are going to die, set right your home. And as he was going, God stopped the servant of God, Isaiah, and told him, go back to my king called Hezekiah. The prophet said, now only you'd send me. I told him he is going to die. Now, my son is praying. Prayer transforms the world. Prayer moves the hands which moves the whole world. If you kneel before God, your God will stand before you. If your God stands before you, nothing in the world can stand against you. This is the truth. Do you want the healing? You need to set right your life for prayer. And Hezekiah has prayed. Look at him. He is turning toward Jerusalem and he is crying. He is saying, I am his God. How can I die of sickness when my God is called God of Rapha, the one who kills me? So go and tell him four things. Number one, your God has heard your prayer. Your God, secondly, saw your tears. Third, your God is going to add 15 more years for your life. And fourth, you are turning towards Jerusalem temple, the holy presence of God you are searching. So God likes that. God loves the people who hunger for his presence. Even in the adverse situation, everybody, the enemy is tying up human being when they are affected with a little sickness, with the fear, worries and anxieties. But blessed is the man who turns his fear into prayer. Yes. And that's what Hezekiah has done. So go and tell him, he is the man who hungered for my presence. So in 3 days, he will rise up and he will come to Jerusalem and he will praise me in the temple. My dear friends, do you want the healing? The Lord is the same. He is calling you. Let the whole world tell that you are sick. Don't lose courage. Stand up and you will be healed. You will be saved.